Australian Chancellor Carl Nehammer set to meet with Russian President Vladimir Putin in Moscow on Monday. The meeting would be the first face-to-face encounter between Putin and a European leader since Russia invaded Ukraine on February 24th, which triggered a broad Western effort to isolate Moscow. Nehammer's trip comes after he met Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky on Saturday. The Austrian leader hopes to encourage dialogue between Moscow and Kyiv. He admits the chances of achieving progress are slim. Nehammer says he has consulted with the EU's top officials, but is making the trip on his own initiative. Austria is militarily neutral and is not a member of NATO.
Pope Francis calls for an Easter ceasefire in Ukraine to pave the way for peace through real negotiation. During his Palm Sunday address, the pontiff denounced wars where defenseless civilians have suffered heinous massacres and cruelty. The pope did not explicitly cite Russia's invasion, but he has repeatedly denounced the war and the suffering brought to innocent people. The appeal comes after Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky said Kyiv was readying for decisive and important battles in the country's east. At the same time, Zelensky says there are parallel efforts to end the war through diplomacy.
Ukraine's economy is likely to contract at a staggering pace this year due to Russia's invasion. Based on its latest report, the World Bank says Ukraine's GDP will likely shrink by 45%, excluding the impact of physical infrastructure destruction. And that magnitude is still subject to a high degree of uncertainty related to the duration and intensity of the war. As for Russia, World Bank expects its economy to contract 11% due to punishing financial sanctions imposed by the U.S. and its Western allies. The Eastern Europe region, comprising Ukraine, Belarus, and Moldova, is also forecast to show a GDP contraction of 30.7% this year due to shocks from the war and disruption of trade.
Local pump prices set for a rollback for the second straight week. Gasoline prices are poised to go down by up to 1 peso and 20 centavos per liter, and diesel by 50 centavos per liter. Kerosene may see the biggest price cut of up to 3 pesos per liter. The decline follows lower trading prices at the world market last week after China extended its COVID-19 lockdown, on top of Russian forces retreating from some key Ukrainian cities. Meanwhile, power rates are expected to go up this April due to higher generation charge. Meralco will release the rate of its price hike today.